Hello and welcome to the TerraPura Non-League Show. And for the first time this season, we're pleased to say we are coming to you from the Bibby Financial Services Stadium, home of Worthing FC. They had problems with their pitch at the start of the season, FIFA not allowing them to play on their home ground. That's been sorted and they are here today and they're hosting Lowestoft Town in the FA Trophy. These two teams met earlier on in the season in the league away at Lowestoft, and the visiting team today came away with a 1-0 victory in that game. Worthing, they got their first victory in 210 days in the midweek, a 5-0 thrashing of Lancing in the Sussex Senior Cup. They'll be hoping that that form will carry themselves into this cup fixture, and we'll bring you all the highlights and reaction later on in the show. So I'm here with Sam, Worthing fan. How long have you been coming down here?
About 4 years now. So, yeah, seen the ups and downs, but all good, all good.
So, speaking of ups and downs, I'll touch on last season in a second, but what's it finally like to be playing back at home?
It's good. It's nice not having to make the trip all the way to Bognor, but, yeah, it's nice. We feel more at home here. Because our players, when they're not at home, it just doesn't feel right. So, yeah, it's nice. It is nice being back.
And have you found that, because obviously it's been a very slow start to the season?
Yeah. We seem to be playing much better back at home now, because playing at Bognor, just because we've got different, like, the pitches, if we're playing on grass at Bognor and not here, it's kind of like, you know, mess the players' heads a little bit. So, yeah, basically.
So have you got a favourite memory so far from this season? Any highlights?
Probably the last game, winning against Lancing in the Sussex Senior Cup. It's just nice getting back to winning ways and scoring goals. So
210 days between victories.
Yeah, it's been hard, but you know, all the fans have been here. So 350 for a cup game on a Tuesday night, it's not bad. It's really good support as well. And singing, so you know, it's even better.
Happy days. And going back over the years, what's your favourite memory in the 4 years you've been coming down here?
Probably the promotion up to the Bosic Premier Division. Yeah, that was a good day, that. The semi-finals, winning 7-0, then 3-0, like 10-0, you know, a clean sheet in both games. Like, playoffs supposed to be pretty hard because, you know, they're both teams work for it. And to get to the final and win 3-0, it was brilliant. And a penalty save from Ricky Banks, it's even better. It's just really good.
So, Lowestoft, we've played them early in the season, lost, but new mentality. What do we think? Can you give us a prediction on today's score?
I'm probably going to say 2-1 Worthing, because they're 17th in the league. We've won last game, and you know, when we start winning, it goes well. So a strong team as well. So I think a 2-1 win today.
Here we are then, ahead of the kickoff. Let's run through the two teams. We'll start with the home team. Worthing, of course, wearing all red today. In goal, number one, Lucas Covelin. Number two, Joel Colbran. Number three, Sam Rents. Number four, coming into the team from the victory over Lancing, is Reece Hallard. Number five, Alfie Young. Number six, Raoul Ovenden. Number seven, Alex Parsons. Number eight, Kieran Pammant. Number nine, Captain Ben Pope. Number 10, also coming into the team, is Jazz Rance. And number 11, Ruben Schneider. The substitutes for Worthing: Henry Watson, Matt Boiling, Harvey Sparks, Luca Reitman and Reese Meekums. So for Lowestoft Town, wearing their traditional all-blue kits. In goal, number one, Ben Dudzinski. Number two, Captain Travis Colt. Number three, Harry Barker. Number four, Adam Smith. Number five, Rory McCauley. Number six, Freddie Westlake. Number seven, Callum White. Number eight, Sam Borough. Number nine, Josh Greenleaf. Number 10, Harvey Hodd. And number 11, Cruz Nyadzeo. And only two substitutes named for Lowestoft Town, and that's Leon Wren and Elvis Putnins. They make four changes to the team. And it'll be Worthing kicking off with Pope, and the Mackerels will kick from right to left as we're looking on.
Let's get behind the ball this afternoon. Come on, you Reds!
And referee Craig Green. Just making sure we're ready to kick off this FA Trophy qualifying round game. I think I've reached the heady heights of round four in this competition. That was back in the 2003-2004 season. Lowestoft Town have only reached the second round proper, and that was back in 71-72, so not a competition that has been kind to them over the years. I think keeping possession at the back. Adam Hinshelwood seen an upturn in form for his team since taking over, and of course moving back home. Pressure on from Hod. McCovellin, the man back in goal, takes possession. Nice turn under pressure from Hallard. Releases just over the halfway line. The ball over top, one for Pammant to get on the end of. Come defending at the other end, but picked up in the middle by a red shirt. Once again, Worthing have the ball at the back. Rents can bring it forwards, looking for options ahead of him. He's able to check back, and Worthing will build up again. Here's Young, looking for a long ball over the top. Here's Schneider, looking to get on the end of it. Bluehead gets that one away. Schneider does get on that one, just to flick one over. And eventually the ball comes off Schneider. Immediately Ben Pope, right on the goalkeeper, Dudzinski, trying to make life difficult for him. It's a low cross. They've worked on that one over the top from Hallard, who come in off the 6-yard line and was free. Something obviously they've worked on in training. But Worthing allowed to bring the ball forward a long way before a challenge goes in. Pope wasn't strong enough and loses out, so he looks to chase and win the ball back, but Lowestoft did well initially, and then Yadzeo wins the ball in a dangerous position. Coming across was Alfie Young. Yadzeo seemed to take too long to pick his option. Hallard in field to Ovenden, and here is the ball on for Schneider, who has got lots of space, and it's time to pick out a cross, and then headed behind his own goal by Harry Barker. I think take the quick corner, trying to catch Lowestoft unawares. Two blue shirts got across, but Rance has found space himself. He thought about the shot and then decided to check back and to his left foot. Headed away by Nyadzeo. A solid start for Worthing this. Most of the play in the Lowestoft half. Ovenden, and now Hallard, back to Young. Rents had made an option. His forward ball was intended for Schneider. Rents gets on with it quickly, and Rance has come in behind. Colt came back and wins a free kick. Did bounce up awkwardly for the fullback. Worthing with a line of six at the back and head that one away. Then a little elbow in the back, but ball breaks for Pope, and then Parsons just runs out of room. And Barker with a throw just inside the Worthing half, launches one. And not giving up there, Nyadzeo, making a nuisance of himself. Worthing eventually get the ball back to Young. Now Rents has got time to look forward and pick his pass. Under pressure was Rance, but Worthing keep possession for now. He's allowed to dribble up forward, and lots of space here for Pammant to turn and go at the defence. Pammant has gone. And here is Parsons. Flashes one wide. First for Pagham and then for Shoreham, who of course won the league. They'll throw up. And here is Pammant. He's under pressure. He keeps possession of the ball, though. And Rents now. He could bring that down. He slips and he's recovered just in time to get the ball out to Schneider. And running back is White. Worthing got possession. And that's Ovenden. Colbrand to the feet of Rance, who nice little touch and turn. He thought about the shot again, then checks back onto his right foot, and then does get the shot away, takes a deflection. Comfortable for the keeper. Be Pammant leaving it for Rents, who curls one in away from goal and headed away initially. Worthing maintain possession on the edge, and Parsons is allowed to turn, takes a little nick, and Rance gets a toe end on it and holds off the challenge of White, and then keeps going, and then comes off an arm, but it falls and it's in the back of the net. Pope, it hit the arm of the defender. But Pope was there on the edge of 6 yards to smash the ball in the back of the net. So Ben Pope follow-ups. His hat-trick heroics in midweek against Lancing with the opening goal. And the chance from the Worthing fans behind the goal. Feed the Pope and he will score. That's his seventh goal of the season. And Worthing take a deserved lead. It's Worthing 1, Lowestoft Town 0. Chatting to a few of the fans before the game, they were saying that Worthing have started the last few games very well but haven't scored or got the rewards for that play. Well, they've certainly taken the most of their chance here today and have taken the early lead. Rents making the run down this wing with Schneider, and he's still on for the pass, which he takes now, and Rance has gone on ahead of him and they look to play in behind. Cole, the captain, had held him off. And then Barker and Cole between them do well. Calm chest from Young. Rents spreads the play over for Parsons. It's not going to reach him, though. Now Nyadzeo does well and turns, just overruns the ball, though. Parsons got a tug of the shirt and a free kick to Lowestoft Town, looking to respond to Pope's goal. Referee not happy with the ball. And Adam Smith, a chance to put one in the box. Six Lowestoft shirts on the edge of the box. It's floated towards that and headed towards by the captain, Cole. And that is deep, and that should be for Covelin, who gathers it at the second attempt. And then Rents, always the early option out for him. Omidon to Hallard. And then here goes Parsons, who's in behind the fullback. It's Yadzeo, who's come back to defend. That's a deep cross in. Pope heads it back across goal. Nearly turned in by Pammant. Cleared away. A tussle with Alex Parsons. Rents. Now Schneider. And coming in behind is Rance, who's got away from Smith and gets a good cross in, and it's, well, it fell to Pammant. He wasn't expecting it. It hit his back foot and rolled comfortably to Dzinski. Either way, Greenleaf sets down with purpose and marks his run up. There's a six-man wall for Worthing. As Greenleaf strikes slow, cleared away. And then a step from Smith. And Pammant, and then Pope. Hoicks one forward. Rance can bring this down, which he does. And then completed the rash clearances was Rents, Niedzeo. And then he lunges in, keeps possession. Works the ball to Hard, who plays one over for Greenleaf, who's made a great run in behind Colburn. Niedzeo with space. He thought about the shot again, and that nearly broke through to Greenleaf. He just got his feet muddled. It has to be said, Lowestoft Town growing in this game. Ten minutes left of the half. Still Worthing 1, Lowestoft Town 0. Young with the ball at the back. Now Rents. Lowestoft allowing Worthing to have the ball in his deep positions. And there's space for Pammant, who checked back and then went forward. And Pope's made an intelligent run off him. Instead, he looked to find Rance. Seen less of Ovenden and Hallard in the last few moments of the game. But here's Pammant again. He's just running behind. Pope again's made that great run in. And again, Pammant just picks the wrong option. Parsons got his head to it. Ball breaks here for Rance. He brings it down. Goes into the area. He's still going. And it's just past the upright. He shouldn't have been allowed to get through. He did get through. It took a deflection on its way through. It's going to be a corner. Set pieces. Corners certainly seem to be something Worthing have worked on. We've seen a couple of varieties. And now you've got a group of four players bunched up as it's delivered deep to the back post. And Fressel was blown before Young got his head to it. It's McCauley back to Dudzinski. Now Lowestoft looking to build from back to front, but they've pushed four men up onto Worthing's back line here. Cole's got time to turn. Rolls it forward and gets 1-2 with White. Greenleaf, it just comes off his heel. And Hallard does find Pammant. And making a run in behind his Rance, if he can be found. It's just over hit from Pammant. Rance could have been in. Greenleaf just runs across his marker and he made an intelligent run in behind the Worthing defence there. Instead, Lowestoft are forced to come back. But again, Cole's got space on his near side. Here he is on the ball. He can bring it into Worthing territory. Then a little check back and Smith takes over in the middle of the park. He had Zayo on the opposite side. Comes in on his right. He thinks about the shot and takes the shot. Gets underneath it. Over the top. But better from Lowestoft. Worthing just keeping possession. Seeing out the half. It looks like Lowestoft are happy to let them go back there and regroup. Young now with the ball at the back. Ovenden has made the option to the right, Rents to the left, and it goes with Rents. The low ball up for Pope, who's allowed to turn, and Rance out to Parsons. Now there is space for Ovenden and Rents. And that's the end of the first half. Worthing fans, players will be happy. They lead 1-0 at the break, courtesy of Ben Pope's goal on 15 minutes. Well deserved, it must be said, for their endeavours at the start of this game. We'll see what happens in the second half, but the half-time score here is Worthing 1, Lowestoft Town 0.
Let's go behind the lads for the second half. Come on, you Reds!
Here we are then. And the second half, Lowestoft Town. Kicking off with Josh Greenleaf. Kicking from right to left. And immediately to play one in over the top. It almost backfires as Rance picks it up and holds off the challenge of Westlake. And then the ball comes back to Rents. Ovenden. Again, Rents made an option and out Schneider. Cole making it difficult for him. Cole hoping that it would go out of play, but did enough to prevent the Worthing winger from getting a cross in. There's pressure. Calm play from Hallard. Now Parsons. Just wasn't strong enough. And then Hallard dived in. Watching the danger was Colbrant. Interesting to see how Lowestoft come out in the second half. They were quite passive, allowing Worthing to dictate a lot of the first half. My J.D. Gallagher coming up through the ranks. His playing career stopped due to injury. Then got his coaching badges and became reserve team manager and joint first team manager with Mickey Chapman, and now is in sole charge. Lofted forward, met by the head of Hallard. Here's Parsons. He chips on in. Pope gets in ahead of his marker. The keeper came, maybe got something on it, not sure. Looked like he certainly got some of the man. No appeals for anything. Ormondon back to Colbrant. Again, were they knocking the ball around at the back? Ball for Rance, who drops his shoulder and turns. Gonzeo with a late challenge with the referee waste play on the early cross in. And coming in was Pammant, cleared away by Barker. Schneider is allowed to go on and get his shot away. And he doesn't hit the target, and the groans come from around the ground. Smith travels with the ball. And then gets the return. And then a little chip ball out for Barker. Takes the touch and plays it into the edge of the box. Headed away initially. And then volleyed clear by Rance. Barker would watch that one. Greenleaf finally gets the ball down. Can run the Worthing defence. Gets the ball through the legs of Parsons. Then plays one to the edge of the area. Smith with far too much time. Try to pick out Yadzeo. His volley came off the Worthing defender and then back off the Lowestoft winger. And it will be a goal kick. Out for Schneider. He does get a cross in. Pope gets up. The keeper misses it. Volleyed towards by Pammant. But he didn't really catch it. And Dzinski claims. And Colt runs at the Worthing midfield before going back to White. Greenleaf lets it run. And so does Covelin. Worthing slowing the clock down, and that's unnecessary from Greenleaf. Oh, Greenleaf will be the first player. So that rush challenge from Greenleaf earns him the first yellow card of the game. So it's halfway point of the second half. Hallard beaten to it in the air by Colt. Coming back to help out was Pammant, but Lowestoft keep the attack going, and Colt, the captain, and now Nyadeo in a central position, looking for support, having to go back to Smith, who lofts one up towards Barker, takes it down well. Better this from Lowestoft. And here's the substitute, Rent, gets a cross in. Is it going to come all the way through to Greenleaf? Coughlin denies him. But Worthing don't clear their lines, and still the attack's going. Best moment of the game by far for Lowestoft. Heart in the mouth moment there as Greenleaf found himself free, 6 yards out. It sparked a bit of fight from Lowestoft that was been missing in the previous 60 odd minutes of this game. And they've got a free kick in a very, very dangerous position, which Smith will take. He lets it in. Coughlin comes, doesn't get there. And it's cleared away. Another nervy moment.
Reece Meekums.
So Jess Rance will make way. Reece Meekums coming on to replace him. White, the deep throw up the line, headed away by Rents. Smith then with the blue head. And then he gets one out wide for Bark, who takes a heavy touch, but bring the ball forward. It's being held up initially by Parsons, but then gets the ball to the substitute, Rent, who gets a cross in. And then Schneider took a risk initially and then forced to smash the ball out for a corner. Worthing still lead, courtesy of that Ben Pope goal in the first half. Lowestoft Town looked to reply from this corner, whipped in by Smith. Underneath the keeper, Coughlin gets a double fist to that one, and then turned back towards goal by Barker. Thought about closing down Dzinski. He somewhat slices his clearance, and Parsons will take this one on, but he's brought down by Colt. Just a bit too enthusiastic. And Worthing have a free kick just inside the Lowestoft Town half. And again, the ball played Schneider in his first time layoff. Back to Meekums, who's got space in the area. He checks back onto his right foot, goes for goal. Straight at the goalkeeper. So Schneider will be going off. And Harvey Sparks comes on to replace him. It's their 512. Another good crowd here at the Bibby Financial Services Stadium. Lowestoft Town with a chance to put a ball in. Flicked on by the centre-back McCauley, and then his opposite centre-back Freddie Westlake's brought down by Ovenden, and this is a free kick just over 25 yards out. And Colt, the captain, wanting to lead by example. Worthing put together a four-man wall. In fact, Coughlin waves away Colburn. It'll be a three-man wall, which will line up just on the edge of the area. And Smith's going to pop this one in to the box. And it's a high-hanging ball headed towards goal. Great save from Coughlin, and then headed away. And Coughlin goes down. Great save from the goalkeeper, Coughlin, and then Colburn headed away. when Lowestoft looks certain to score. Great save from Covalent. Keeps Worthing in the lead. Late goals have been Worthing's problem in recent weeks. And a cross in. Volley towards goal by McCauley. Looking to put the pressure on once more. The flick on from Cole. McCauley, who's now playing as a striker, gets there, gets the cross in. Cole Brown heads away. And Pammant volleys one over for Pope to chase. Again, Dzinski comes a long way. And then plays a risky pass and nearly plays himself into trouble. Well, White and Dzinski somehow played themselves out of trouble. And then White gives the ball away. And Ovenden saw the keeper of his line. Hallard just gets it out to Sparks. Sparks having a run. The defence just getting into the area, winning his team a corner. Corner whipped in. Underneath the give out towards by Pope. And somehow he couldn't direct his header on target. That should have been game over. Great whipped in ball. And now Lowestoft pushing more men forward. Pammant gets the flick on Pope. And over on that far side was Meekham's. But Westlake got a foot in. Strong hold-up play from Yadzeo. And he goes to take on Sparks. And so he lost the ball momentarily, but then rolls it out. Plays one infield. It's now out with Barker. He's got Pammant forcing the cross. Meekham's let that bounce, and Smith initially got in, and then he pulls down Meekham's. Silly from the number four, and he'll be the second player to go into the book. In the 89th minute then, Worthing have a free kick. 10 yards inside their own half with a 1-0 lead over Lowestoft Town in the FA Trophy first qualifying rounds. Alfie Young to take this kick to Parsons. It's over his head. And a long throw headed away by Hallard. As Lowestoft Town look to work the line. McCauley, the centre-back, up. Wins that one. Came off Colbrand, though. Again, Barker. Tense finish here. Ball flicked on Greenleaf. Can hold it up. Colbrand got it clear initially. Barker. Smith. Looks to play in behind. Covalent. Looked for a moment. He took too long towards going towards it. And there's going to be 6 minutes of added time. 6 minutes. Sparks, great first touch from him. Pope's in the middle. And here is Pope. This could seal it for Worthing. 2-0. Right at stoppage time, Ben Pope doubles his tally and Worthing's tally. And surely that should be game over. All 11 players on the pitch go to celebrate. The captain has led by example up front. He's scored his fifth goal in 4 days. And Worthing surely have their second victory after going 210 days without one. Ben Pope, after a brilliant first touch, it must be said, from substitute Harvey Sparks. So Lowestoft Town now have it all to do. They've got 5 minutes or so of stoppage time to get two goals to take this tie to a replay. Adam Smith with a chance to put one in the box and maybe set up a tense finale. Another deep hanging ball. Coughlin comes a long way and this time gets it and then lays on the ball. He'll try and eat up as much time as possible. Just throws a long one up to Pammant and Meekins had run in behind, but Pope in turn and Sparks on the far side keeps it in play. And here comes Rents, headed towards the goal, and it's a third! Pammant! The second goal in stoppage time puts the gloss on this tie. It was a nervy 20 minutes or so for the Rebels, but two goals in stoppage time, and that a deft header from Pammant, getting his fifth goal in three games. Well, of course, Lowestoft Town pushing men forward and Greenleaf's offside. Meekins being stood up by White and lays back to Sparks. They're just playing with the ball themselves in the box. Sparks still going. And Meekins takes over, runs out of pitch as he looked to play in Pope. And he'll play out the final couple of minutes of stoppage time. Cole gets a flick on. There's another one for Greenleaf to chase. Cole, and he holds off the chance of Colburn, but coming back was Harvey Sparks. Coughlin will let that roll out, and that is it, the end of a game where Worthing were in control for much of it, but for the final 20 minutes or so, Lowestoft Town make a real fist of it. 1-0 was the score until the 90th minute, as the 6 minutes and groan of stoppage time was announced. Ben Pope doubled his lead, got Worthing second before Kieran Pammant added the gloss to the final score, which finished here Worthing 3, Lowestoft Town 0.
Performance levels the last few weeks have been good. Like, since I've come in, we changed the shape against Leatherhead, and since then, you know, we've really done well. We've dominated the ball, and apart from 1:45 minutes at Tooting, where I think we was just nowhere near it, we've, you know, really done well. So it's just keep stressing to the lads, if we keep our performance levels at the level they were, that the wins would come. And you know, two clean sheets is big for us as well. Yeah, and just if this group gets confident and on a roll, I believe they can, you know, do good things.
So late goals have been sort of a bit of an Achilles heel over the last few weeks. Were there nervy moments from the bench? I was speaking to Reece and he seemed to think things were quite calm today.
Yeah, I mean, that's probably something I've got to look at, really. It's probably stemming from the bench, you know, so desperate as well for the lads to get across the line and get the win. It's probably coming, rubbing off on the pitch, if you like, with the way I was conducting myself. So yeah, I tried to stay a bit calmer, and you know, it seems to have been working. There's one opportunity I think they really had with a great save from Lucas. So every player's playing their part in the team, and yeah, like I say, we just added some good young players to the team, local from the area, and really brought into the way we want to play.
Two substitutions that actually ended up making this game very comfortable. Sparks in particular setting up the final two goals, and Meekham certainly had energy. Is that the importance now, that you've got that burst of energy coming on off the pitch to freshen the game up?
Yeah, I think it's really important. Like I say, the squad's getting better all the time and growing, and you know, one stage a couple of weeks ago we had five defenders on the bench, so you know, now we've got them options with you know, Reece has got bags of quality, and same with Harvey. So you know, I just think it's really healthy at the moment. Like, if you've got you know, that quality from the bench, it just gives the person that's got the shirt that incentive that they've really got to up their game to stay in. And you know, I think that's all healthy competition that we've got now within the squad.
And lastly, obviously 2 wins out of 2 in the cup. League form is important. Needham Market up next. Can you take this into your league campaign?
Yeah, hopefully that'll be the all-important question will be this time next Saturday, really. But, you know, that's what we're hoping to do. We've just got to treat every game as if it's like, you know, a cup final, if you like. As cliche as it sounds, that's how it's got to be for us. I watched Sheffield United Leeds last night, and you know, Sheffield United went top of the league, and it was sheer determination and hard work. And you know, it was a derby, but they you know, run their socks off and worked hard. And that's how we've got to be treating every game now. So yeah, we're hopeful now. Like I say, this young group gets a bit of confidence, and you know, they should take it into the next game.
It's unbelievable. It's all come together finally. I think we're coming against Hendon, doing good results, and I think we finally got the win. And once we got the momentum, I feel like we're going to go on and win more and more now. So I feel like now we've built the momentum, we can take that into more games. So yeah, really positive.
And it was a real controlled performance until about 20 minutes to go. And did the nerves sort of set in on the pitch a little bit?
I don't think it did. I think as a team we stuck together well. I think, of course, there's some sort of nerves flying around. But overall, I think it was all right, to be fair. I think not too bad.
And coming back home, so now 2 wins in 4 at home. That is this going to make a big difference to the season, or has that made a difference to the team, or has it been the change of manager? What's been the catalyst, do you think?
I think definitely the management helps them massively. I mean, the way they implement new styles of play, the positivity in the team, I think that helped build momentum going into the games as well. I think coming back home, the fans, everyone's on big spirits as well. So I think a bit of everything, a bit of management, players, everything coming together, and we're finally going on and showing what we can actually do.
On a personal level, you've played with a lot of freedom out there today. Have you been given any specific instructions, or are you just allowed to play your game?
Yeah, I mean, we've been told mainly just to keep calm, keep collected. So a lot of times in the earlier in the season, we'll just be panicking, we'll just get it, smash it away, we panic a lot. So the main message is just to keep control, don't get nervous, no pressure, and just relax and enjoy yourself, really. So I think that message on board has helped a lot.
So there we have the end of another very eventful TerraPura non-league show. Worthing's second win of the season following 210 days without one. And actually, our first ever coverage of a victory for Worthing. That's right, we've covered them a few times on the TerraPura non-league show. This is the first time they've got victory, and it's in the FA Trophy. Well, what can I say other than make sure you tune in this time next week for another edition of the TerraPura non-league show.